to Lighthouse Missionary Baptist Church morning worship service. It is good to be here, and we are blessed to have those who are viewing at this time, and those who will be tuning in as the service goes on, because you are blessed. Because of you, we know that the word is not only going out, but it's being received. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. For he satisfied the longing soul and filled the hungry soul with goodness. Let you be along with us as we read our statement of belief. We believe that God is the creator of all things, that his son Jesus Christ was born of the Virgin Mary and died on Calvary's cross to pay the ransom for our sins. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who is our God and comforter, as we journey through this life. We believe that all scripture is the absolute and inspired word of God, our roadmap and guide as to how we are to live our lives. We further believe that the church is the people called by God to spread the good news of the gospel to the entire world, and to support, edify, and lift up its members in their time of need. Those of you that are viewing and know this song, great song of the church, the old Christian song. Sing along with us as we sing hymn 340, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Yes.
Control high blood pressure.
Our first thing to prepare myself to come and share our scripture lesson with us for this morning.
Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the stream rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the wind blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. May God add a blessing to the reading of this word.
We come to the hour of praise, the hour of prayer, praise, and exaltation. And as always, we ask that you will keep your loved ones, your friends, your neighbors, passerbys, the acquaintances you see of us all in prayer, whether it's a voice to you or requested of you. Keep them in prayer this morning, because whether we admit it or not, we all, every day, every journey through this life, stand in the need of prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we come with humble hearts. We come rejoicing that you are who you are, the great I Am, the God of earth. A God that hears and answers prayer. A God that blesses when we are in the need. But a God that does not change. Even though we change all the time. 1 second we're this and the next second we won't be there. We thank you, Lord, because you're long suffering. We thank you that even in spite of our disobedience, in spite of our sinfulness, you have not abandoned us. That you are holding firmly to your word, that you will redeem us, those who will embrace the name of Jesus, those who will allow themselves to follow his path, to be baptized and submerged in the water. We thank you, Lord, that for us, there's hope in this chaotic world we live in. That we have to be fearful. But he gave us common sense, Father. to be cautious. So we just thank you, Lord, for being gone all by yourself, running high yet looking low, tending to all of our needs here on this earth. We thank you, Father, for your Son being gone on Calvary's cross, and for the Holy Spirit that leads, guides, and directs us each and every step we take in life, if we allow them to do so. So, Father, we just thank you and praise you today. We ask, Lord, that you just be in the midst of this service, that you will come down and make your presence felt. Lord, that you would just stir us up, Lord, in such a way that we know that you're here.
Yes.
We know that you on much a part of the service as we are. So thank you, Father, for all that you've done and all that you will do in the midst of our lives. We thank you for what you've been doing with Lighthouse and what you will continue to do, Lord, as long as we follow your will. Undergird us as we plan ahead now for our community awareness and ministry outreach day. And we're bringing the staff back together for one or two more meetings as we firm things up and know exactly what we will do and how our day will flow. So guide us, Father, in our thinking and our deliberations. Just have your way, Lord, with this church, with your servants.
Yes.
And then, Father, we recognize, Lord, that even though we try our very best to be like Christ, that we fall short of the mark, that we allow the world to influence our thinking, that we allow things to come to our hearts that should not be there. So we recognize, Lord, that we have sinned somewhere along the way this past week. We ask for your forgiveness for whatever we have done, Lord, whether it was something we said, Lord, something we done, whether we hurt someone with our words or just the way we cross our eyes. You don't take much time to offend people. But we ask, Father, for your forgiveness as we lay our sins down on your throne right now.
Yes, yes.
Forgive us. Cleanse us, Lord. Toss those sins, Father, this past week far away from us. They might not rise up, Lord, to trouble us again in this life. But we need your strength, Lord.
Yes.
We can't do this thing called life by ourselves. We need your strength to be able to hold on and hold out against Satan. He's coming at us from every direction. And we cannot let up, and we certainly can't let our defenses down. We need your strength, Lord, to navigate through this life. We need your strength in dealing with neighbors, friends, acquaintances, people on the job. We need your strength, Lord, to do what we need to do to survive each and every day of this life. So, Father, bless us as we go through this service. We ask that you will bless every song, that you will bless your word, that you will bless every shall praise that will go up on this day, that it may be pleasing in your sight. And then, Father, we ask that you prepare us for this coming week. We don't know what lies ahead. We know that certain things are coming down the pipe, doctor's appointments, hearing with the VA, Whatever it is, Father, we leave it all in your hands. We ask a special blessing for our first duty and the spasms that she's experiencing out of her back, but you just touch her back with the man, Lord, and just ease those spasms that she can function as she would like. And then, Father, I want to bless all of our members, especially those who you often call our action team membership. Undergird them, Lord, bring them back, show them what it is they need to do. Show them how they can make their life complete. Show them why they cannot succeed in doing what they like to do in life. Just show them, Lord, what's missing. Which is being here and fellowship with your people, Lord. That we can pray with them, pray for them, that we can shout and rejoice with them. That they can have a new and intimate relationship with you. World can easily pull us from your grace, Lord. But bring them back, Father, that is our need. That is our prayer. Again, bless all of our family members who stand in the need of prayer. Primarily, those who just need to hear a word from you, Lord. They need that assurance that things will be better. The assurance that even though an illness or sickness has them down, that you are God all by yourself, that you can bring to me, that you can give to them for what the world cannot provide. So bless us, Father. Strengthen us and keep us. Even as we continue trying to live in the midst of this rampant violence that has swept its way across our entire nation.
Yes.
We leave it on your throne, Lord. We ask him that you bring it to the end. Man has tried and man has failed. But you, Father, can do all things except the fear. Bring this to an end, Lord. We know that you have given us over to your living mind to do as we please and not of your children, Lord, are choosing to go down the wrong paths. Father, do the only you can do. Bring us into your peace. We don't ask for a hurt. But bring some more peace in all our communities. That our children can play. That the adults can sit on the steps and converse or even go down to the corner store in peace and without fear of their lives. Bless Father's children, keep us all, for it's our humble prayer. Amen. And fighting with Satan today. Trying to determine on good footing. Seeing this idea in my head never was not going to work. Too sporty today. Not allowing me to do what I needed to do to go in there to get what I needed to have. But you know, Satan's lying. You may have shut down one option. But God, you always provide. I love that. Told me what to do, and I went at it. I can't remember the last time that I had a handwritten transcript. Way back yonder. But that's all right. We want to just share with you for a few minutes from that thought. What are you building your life upon? Now, we're not reading the scripture lesson, but just going through the message for the day. What are you building your life upon? Now, as I think of that, I think about the millionaires, the multi-millionaires, and the billionaires. What they have built their life upon, and it's really evident they built it upon what? Whether generational wealth or wealth they accumulated by making themselves self-made millionaires, multi-millionaires, and even billionaires. Just a quick look back in time will tell us the story of what happens when people choose to build their lives on something other than Jesus.
Amen.
Back in the Great Depression, those that had wealth, and their wealth was suddenly gone, could not stand the fact that now they were poor, and found that many people took their own lives, jumping from windows and doing different things because they found themselves in a precarious position. I had wealth yesterday, and now I have none. I don't have to live as a poor person.
Yeah.
I can't function without money.
Yeah.
So we find many people like that are caught up in chasing elusive dreams or the desire for worldly things and wealth. That they never take the time to think about what their lives have been built upon. That is, until the storms of life begin to blow and all they have built crumbles under their feet. For many, they know that Jesus is real. Some know Jesus, even call themselves Christians. But I want you to know that just standing on the rock is not enough. We must and need to be dedicated to Christ. We must be in a committed relationship with Him.
Amen.
That simply means that we must trust Him completely in every area of our lives. We can't just say, well, I'm going to trust you in this area. But when it comes to my finances and the lifestyle I like to live, keep that in my hands. We must understand today that life that is built on the shifting and changing emotions on mankind, or on worldly virtues or morals. It's not solid. Soon as something contrary happens, soon as there is an earth-shattering event that disturbs the stock market or causes a drastic change in how you used to live, your anchor simply will not hold. This is why so many people in life crash and burn, as it were. Because the world, sadly, only gives us false hope. And the promise of greater and a fuller life. But I want you to know that if those that choose to follow the ways of the world, to travel down those paths in life, we'll find out that soon as the storms of life begin to blow, that their anchors will not hold. And their lives will come crashing down all around them, just like their house built on sand. For those who put their trust totally in Jesus, we have the assurance that no matter how rough the storm may be, or the force of the wind or waves coming up against us, we always have the hope, love, and the enduring rock of Jesus to seek shelter in. You see, there are other folks, they'll be running hither and yonder, calling everybody they know to get them out of their predicament. But all we've got to do is to seek shelter in Jesus. All we have to do is to call on the name of Jesus. Just say, Jesus, we need you right now. Jesus, come by here and help me right this boat of life that I am. The waves are trying to knock me out. Water's trying to come in and flood my boat. But I want you, Father, to come in and make things right. You know, it's easy to follow the ways of the world. Say, it makes everything seem so good that you just gotta have it. And walk around after it without even thinking. Just put an ad in the paper and say that there's some money to be had. And see how many people will flock trying to get a piece of it. Because it reminds me of the man out in the Midwest who hid this treasure and put the word out that whoever will find this treasure will be a rich person, because what he had in that box was worth more than $1 million. And folk from all over the United States would go to that area searching through the hills and deserts and the mountains, trying to find this treasure. There are some that died in the process. Some were hurt in the process. Then there is one that claimed to have found it, but there's some contradicting reports that the man that hid the treasure told this person what it was. Simply because too many people were putting their lives on the line just for notoriety, just for a little while. What is your house built upon? Or your life? When we say house, we're speaking about your life. What is it built upon? Yeah. Is it built upon a strong faith in Jesus? Yeah. Or is it built upon that dream that you keep on chasing but cannot grow hold to? Yeah. There should be a sign to you that it's not for you to have. If it's that elusive, then God is telling you something. Leave it alone. If you're chasing after worldly desires and lusting after wealth, God wants you to know it's not for you. If wealth was yours to have, He would have provided it already. But to chase after it and to sacrifice everything you have trying to get something that really is not for you to have is telling us that your life is built on dreams that are not real, on hope that is not going to come into fruition. Because you know the old saying with wealthy people, the more they have, the more they want.
Amen.
Why? Because Jesus is not in the midst. Let the stock market completely crash, eradicating all the billions of dollars that people have in millions, and see what happens. Lives will come crashing down. People will be taking their lives because of the stress and outlook of being one of us. You know, black folk know how to be poor. We know how to get by. We can make do with very little. But when God blesses us with a little something, we are not to squander it. Because then it's just like building your house on sand, as the scripture says. Because in a little while, when the storms of the life rise up, that house will be blown away. I'm going to leave you with these words of Christ that give us hope and assurance. Words that we all know. And it simply be this. Come to me, all you that are weary and heavy laden. Or in some translation, for the burden. Now I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. What are you building your life upon? As we close out our Facebook service this morning, we want to issue the call to discipleship, because we never know who may be viewing this service for the very first time. You never know who the Spirit has pricked the souls of those who may be watching. You know, God moves in mysterious ways.
Yes,
and it's no accident or coincidence that certain people are watching program at certain times, or that certain people are in certain places at a certain time. It's by divine providence. And so we want to take this moment just to say, if you are indeed watching for the first time, or have been watching and have not received Christ as your Savior, we earnestly appeal to you to embrace Him right now. Embrace Him by way of baptism. If you're between churches, We invite you to come and be a member here at Lighthouse. Or just go to a church and affiliate yourself with it. God wants you to be in fellowship with the saints. Some churches do have problems. But it's not every church. One bad apple doesn't spoil the whole bunch. So come back. God is asking and pleading for you to come back into fellowship. Don't step away too long and let the world come in and sway you to do things that you know is not right. And then those have been away for some very long and maybe viewing service today will say something to you that is touching you. Come back to God. God wants you to come back by way of rededicating the faith that you have. You may say that I don't have any faith. That faith is long gone and it's no longer present in my soul. But we want you to know it's there. You just push it down so far that you no longer will recognize it. But God is knocking at your door today. The doors of your heart, the doors of your soul. He's hoping that you're open. Our God will not force you to come to Him. But He will keep knocking at the doors of your heart. He will keep allowing His Holy Spirit to keep your soul words slip my mind, but they put you in your soul, put it in such a way that you know that beyond any shadow of a doubt that you need to make things right with God. God will cause a little turmoil till you get things right. God will cause things not to be right so you know that it is time that I make things right with God. He's coming. He's standing before you. He's knocking on the doors of your heart. His arms are outstretched today. He's calling you. Time is short now. Decision is sure as when you come. And as always, reading the different things that have been posted, the announcement for the week, fall for the week, and other things that you'll see posted for you that you might be in one on the same accord with us here at Lighthouse. And then remember us what you're given, what you budget. You know, it's easy to say that we don't have. But God wants you to know that He will bless you as you have blessed Him. Keep it in mind when you budget. You don't have to get paid out a loan to give to the church. But budget out a few dollars and send it to Lighthouse. That will enable us to continue doing what we do in the Southwest Germantown community. God bless you all. We'll see you same time, same place, same station, God willing, on next week.